Good evening, Rowan. It's the 19th of November 2017 and it's about 11 p.m. And obviously this is my usual Sunday evening video to reassure you I haven't been seducing any priests over the weekend, so you can relax. Because obviously I'm saving myself for my beloved, because he's so wonderful and we're made for each other and we just can't wait to be in each other's arms, on our bed of roses, on our silk sheets, having a really good time, keeping each other warm in this cold weather. Cold despite global warming. And resisting tyrannous authorities all at the same time. We just can't wait. Anyway, this evening... Oh, first of all, I should say that obviously I haven't been hanging around the Catholic parish of St. Urban's hoping to bump into any pretend astrophysicists in order to save your skin. And nor have I come out as a lesbian in order to save your gigantic ego. So everything is exactly the same as usual. Nothing ever changes. Anyway... This evening, I thought we could carry on talking about the same subject I was talking about in my last video, which I made on Thursday last week, about some quotations from you that had been published in an article in Christian Today on Thursday. And then on Friday, you gave a radio interview with Premier Christian Radio about Mrs. Zaghari-Radcliffe, who is in jail in Iran at the moment, and she's married to a British man and has dual Iranian and British citizenship. So this has been in the news in the last couple of weeks, and this is what you're talking about here once again in this radio interview. Well, obviously you're talking about other things, you're just pretending to be talking about this. So you say that you think this case can be taken out of political point scoring and international point scoring. So as I've said millions of times before, you like zero-sum games when your opponents are getting the zero-sum, and you don't like political point scoring and international point scoring unless it's you who's doing all the point scoring. If anyone else is scoring points, you don't like it. So you're talking about this in the context of how religious leaders may be able to help in this situation. I should add that it sounds like this radio interview has started in the middle, but in fact it hasn't. I've only accidentally missed a couple of words off at the beginning of the interview, but it sounds like that on their website, like it started in the middle. So if it's been edited, it's not me who's edited it. The whole interview I will play at the end of this video. So you're talking about humanitarian needs that this lady may have being in prison. You don't want to talk about the political situation. So I think you're trying to say that you want to make things better for me because of humanitarian needs, but without actually conceding any ground, like admitting that you've done all this on purpose to try and destroy me, inventing a lot of lies about me and all this kind of thing, a smear campaign behind my back and inciting people to treat me in a cruel way, and also having me put in this situation right now as well, and continuing this abuse and harassment of me, which is still going on. You're trying to say, well, you want to respond to humanitarian needs, but without actually conceding that you've done a very evil thing. I think that's what you're saying here. So, you're talking about religious leaders now being seen as non-political, which, as I said in my last video, is a complete joke coming from you of all people. So you say it's something the Iranian government understands. There is a role for religious leaders in public life, and it's a role which has to do with the fundamental moral issues. or amoral issues in relation to you. And then you say, I think there are some basic moral issues here. So you use basic in the context of sex, don't you? So you've definitely got basic moral issues, because if people don't want sex with you, you try and force them and you try and destroy them. And you conclude they must be lesbians because it's the only explanation your extreme narcissism will accept. There are some basic moral issues here which Christian leaders are in a good position to raise. So I don't think you're going to be raising anything, are you, with your microscopic floppy thing. So you then say there could be other non-Christian religious leaders who could be involved, and that would be even more powerful. So I've made a suggestion as to a non-Christian religious leader who could be involved later in the video, so I'll leave you on tenterhooks to find out who that is later on. So that would be even more powerful. I think you're talking about Madonna's song here, aren't you? The power of goodbye. So the interviewer asks, if you think that the response to this situation from some politicians has slowed this process down. And you say, I think it's been bogged down in international political suspicions. So I've only got international political suspicions. I haven't been looking at evidence and presenting evidence of how you seem to promote everything that goes along with the New World Order, and that you were appointed by Tony Blair, who's also a globalist puppet, and you're the first Archbishop of Canterbury to be appointed from outside of England since 1414, which was before the Reformation. So it's unprecedented in Anglican history. And there's all this propaganda about you being a genius and being very holy, and it's all complete nonsense. And you are lying about 9/11, and you were lying about the London bombings, and you're promoting international taxation, international government structures, and continually pushing the global warming lie. So all of that's just a complete coincidence, I suppose. And that you're making Illuminati signs in videos and in publications. And setting your clock's hands at 9/11 as well. That's obviously a complete coincidence. Yes, so it's been bogged down in international political suspicions because Iran is not the most popular of foreign nations at the moment in many people's eyes. So you're referring to the Illuminati one-eye sign there, aren't you? So, Iran is not the most popular of foreign nations at the moment in many people's eyes, and feels itself to be so. It's also now, of course, being played into domestic political questions because of issues around the Foreign Secretary. So that's Boris Johnson there. He made a mistake in making a statement about this in some committee or something. That's what that's about. So I think it just has to be somehow shifted away from all of that rather murky climate. So you're talking about the global warming hoax again there, aren't you? So they then follow some discussion about which religious leaders would be best placed to help, and there's some information about that later in the video, along with my own suggestion. So then the interviewer asks, how important do you think it is that swift action is taken to secure Mrs. Zaghari-Radcliffe's release? And you say, it's quite clear that Mrs. Zaghari-Radcliffe is somebody with health issues, not surprisingly, given the stressful circumstances in which she's placed. Well, I'm in stressful circumstances, and you've deliberately placed me in these stressful circumstances to try and ruin and destroy me, force me to capitulate, destroy my faith, bring me over to the dark side, give you what you want, so that the way I act will fulfil your narcissistic fantasies that you're superior to everybody else. And you just can't handle the fact that I refused your sex because I think you're a pathetic, inadequate degenerate. So you then say, and above all, I think she's somebody who needs to be reunited with her family. Well, I was quite united with everybody, but you ununited me, so to speak, in order to make me think that I had no option to be involved with you and your perverted associates. So that's why you did all of that to me. And so there would be no reuniting with anybody, would there, Rowan? For me, I mean, because I would have been united all along if it weren't for the fact that you've deliberately had me completely isolated to try and force me to do what you want. And all these fucking lunatics have just gone along with it. So you then say she suffered what appears to be a very grave injustice. Well, I'm still suffering a very grave injustice, and I go on suffering a very grave injustice while people think they've got the right to take my life over, destroy it, and just tip year after year of it down the drain like it's nothing. Well, it is nothing to other people because it doesn't cost them anything, so they don't give a shit. This is why they're doing it to me. They would have never considered it to be in their own best interest to be doing anything like this. And they would have never sacrificed anything of themselves to help me. So as long as they're only sacrificing me, they don't give a shit. So that's other people in my experience. She suffered what appears to be a very grave injustice, and I think that Iran can only gain, internationally speaking, by recognising that an error's been made. Well, you haven't made any error, Rowan. Everything you've done with full knowledge. You've done it on purpose to try and destroy me, destroy my faith, bring me over to the dark side so you can be lording it over me, so you can reinforce your narcissistic fantasies that you're superior to absolutely everybody else. Well, you're not superior to anybody. You're a pathetic, inadequate little mummy's boy. So zip your trousers up and fuck off. You never made any error. Everything you've done on purpose. You know exactly what you're doing. You're a psychopath. You've been practising this art all your life. So you say that Iran can only gain, internationally speaking, by recognising that an error's been made, rectifying that, and so doing its best for the human rights, the human dignity of this family. So I haven't got any rights at all. They've been completely taken away from me. Anybody can abuse and harass me, and there's no comeback on anybody for doing that. And what makes it worse is that these complete and utter nutcases think that they're helping me. It absolutely beggars belief. But I think, anyway, you may be referring to a Marillion song again, White Russian, in the talk about human rights. So I've put that clip in the video later on. Anyway, that's the end of my video for today, because obviously I'll be wanting to go to sleep very soon so I can be dreaming about my beloved all night long, because he's so wonderful and we're made for each other. And of course your wife will be dreaming about her hot new Rastafarian boyfriend who she'll be with the minute that you're out of the picture. We're both going to be keeping warm and resisting tyrannous authorities without you. But don't forget to be alert, because I will be turning up to make a citizen's arrest for terrorism. And also to ask you those awkward questions that I have up my sleeve. Hasta la próxima.
What's going to help most is if this case can be taken right out of political point scoring and international point scoring.
Can you state categorically...
You are fake news.
Sir,
go ahead.
Can you state categorically that...
humanitarian needs, about this woman herself and about her family. And I think religious leaders are well placed to do that.
Because they're seen to an extent as being non-political.
To an extent, yes.
There was a question about the European Union at some point. As the chair of two boards of trustees, charitable trustees, I'm solemnly warned by the charity commissioners about the dangers of expressing any opinion whatsoever about the European Union, so that were I to say in public that I'm deeply anxious about Brexit, that would be very bad of me.
I, Donald John Trump, do solemnly swear
that I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
The office of President of the United States.
But to move towards a conclusion, I don't think I need underline why some of these issues are pertinent literally today. Because we have in the last 12 months seen an extraordinary resurgence across the globe of populism, of assumptions about popular will as the essence of democracy, about national self-determination, and a number of related matters which ought to give us cause for concern.
Because they're seen to an extent as being non-political.
To an extent, yes. And I think it's something that the Iranian government understands. There is a role for religious leaders in public life, and it's a role which has to do with the fundamental moral issues. And I think there are some basic moral issues here. Give it up.
Response then from some politicians to this case has slowed this process down?
I think it's been bogged down in, in both international political suspense.
I control all your thoughts and all your moves. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati. I'm in the Illuminati.
I think it's been bogged down in both international political suspense, because Iran is not the most popular foreign nations at the moment in many people's eyes. I think it's been bogged down in both international political suspense, because Iran is not the most popular foreign nations at the moment in many people's eyes, and feels itself to be so. It's also now, of course, been played into domestic political questions because of issues around the foreign secretary.
I want a campaign against, obviously, I think smoking is a scourge and people should be discouraged from smoking, but I think actively to ban people from doing something that is illegal in a big open space is taking bossiness too far. There you go, that's my view.
Okay, good. So that we put that you. One to one side. Just one other thing, if I may. Mayor Johnson.
I think he knew what the next question I wanted to ask him, which is why he's left.
It's also now, of course, been played into domestic political questions because of issues around the foreign secretary. So I think it just has to be somehow shifted away from all of that rather murky climate.
And what religious figures do you think are best placed to help here?
I'd hope very much that the Foreign Office would be willing to invite people like Archbishop Justin and perhaps the Cardinal to step in. If there were higher representation within the Roman Catholic Church, for example, from the Vatican in the form of the Secretary of State or somebody like that, that would be wonderful. And as I said, it would also be very powerful if there were some non-Christian leaders, some Muslim leaders who might be prepared to lend their voice to this as well.
I wonder, as you've seen events unfold in this case, how important do you think it is that swift action is taken to secure Mrs. Zaghari-Radcliffe's release?
Well, it's quite clear that Mrs. Zaghari-Radcliffe is somebody with health issues.
Late last night when the squire come home and fire in forest lady. She's got both hands.
And late that night when the Lord came home, inquiring of his lady, oh. The servant said on every hand, she's gone with the raggle-tackle gypsies, oh.
The footman memorized the number, but the prince still holds both the slippers. A new dream apprentice for a bed sits in Canterbury Tales.
Oh, what care I for my house and my land? What care I for my money? Oh, I'd rather have a kiss from the wild gypsy's lips. I'm away with the raggle-taggle gypsy. I'm away with the raggle-taggle gypsy. With his hammer.